Welcome all. In this video, we are going to solve some numerical problems based on LVDT, capacitive sensors and RTD. A 40 millivolt output is produced by an LVDT when the core displacement is 8 mm from its zero position. Calculate the core displacement when the output is 25 millivolt. So whenever you get a problem like based on the relationship between input and output, for example, they would have given a particular input output value and they would have asked to find the input for some other output value, or they would have asked to find the output for some other input value. So in case of some dealing with inputs and output, first you have to find the sensitivity with the given input and output values. So sensitivity is given by output by input, that is change in output by change in input. Here the output is changing from 0 to 40 millivolt. The input is changing from zero position to 8 mm. So simply we can write it as output voltage by displacement, because both of them starts from zero. Input and output starts from zero. So directly I can write it as output voltage by displacement. So we'll be getting 40 by 8, that is 5 millivolt per mm. Now again, we are going to use this sensitivity value to determine the new input value. So we know that from the above formula, displacement is equal to output voltage by sensitivity. So output voltage is given as 25. So sensitivity we have calculated it as 5 millivolt per mm. So just substitute it, I'll be getting the new displacement as 5 mm. A parallel plate capacitive transducer has a plate area of 30 mm cross 30 mm and a plate spacing of 0.5 mm. Calculate device capacitance. So we know that the capacitance formula is epsilon R epsilon naught A by D. That is, C is capacitance, epsilon R is the relative permittivity. So here the dielectric is given as R. So for R, epsilon R value is 1. So and we know that epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12 farad per meter. And the area is given as 30 mm cross 30 mm. So we have to convert that into meter. So that is into 10 to the power minus 6, because it's 10 to the power minus 3 into 10 to the power minus 3. And the distance between the plates is given as 0.5 mm. So it's 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. If I solve this, I'll get the value of capacitance as 15.94 picofarads. That is 15.94 into 10 to the power minus 12 farads, or 15.94 picofarads. And on the second part of the sum, the displacement, we have to find the displacement that causes the capacitance to decrease by 6 picofarad. So what we have found is it's 15.94. Now the capacitance has decreased by 6 picofarad. So the new capacitance will be 15.94 minus 6. So that is 9.94 picofarad. So again, I'm going to substitute it in the same formula. C is equal to epsilon naught epsilon R. Sorry, epsilon R epsilon naught area. Area is the same. We do not know the distance. So let's write the new distance as d nu. So we can take d nu to the other side, so that 9.94 will come to the denominator. And if I solve that, the d nu value which I'll be getting is 0.8 mm. This is a new displacement. So change in displacement will be, it's 0.8 minus 0.5. So the displacement that is reducing or decreasing the capacitance value is, when I move it by 0.3 mm, the capacitance will be decreased by 6 picofarad. They have also asked to find the sensitivity of the device. So sensitivity is nothing but change in output by change in input. So here the change in output is 6 picofarad by change in input is 0.3 mm. So that will be 20 picofarad per mm. A platinum resistance thermometer has a resistance of 100 ohms at 25 degrees Celsius. What will be its resistance at 50 degrees Celsius if the resistance coefficient of platinum is 0.00392 per degree Celsius? So for RTD, we have only one formula, that is RT is equal to R0 into 1 plus alpha into del T. So R0 is the known resistance, RT is the unknown resistance, alpha is the resistance coefficient, and del T is the change in temperature. So here the known resistance is 100 ohms, that is at 25 degrees Celsius. So R0 you can take as 100 ohms at 25 degrees Celsius. what we have to find is we have to find R50, that is the resistance at 50 degree Celsius. Okay, so here del T is nothing but 50 degree Celsius minus 25 degree Celsius. So that will be equal to 25. So you can substitute here. So I'll be getting RT is equal to 100 into 1 plus alpha. Alpha value is 0.00392 into 25, because del T is 25. So if I solve this, I'll get the value for RT as 109.8 ohms. So resistance at 50 degrees Celsius is 109.8 ohms. Thank you. Thank you for watching the video.